then, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yes, all right. Well, I'll tell you what.
Is he going to give you the money now?
Mm.
Is he? Like, no. I mean, if you went up to him and said, give me the money now?
Mm, if he had it, yeah.
If he had it?
Yeah.
Actually, I know that he said you've got to wait till Christmas, haven't we?
Mm.
But not here on the big breakfast, no. Tracy, look. Look at this. Would you like that?
Yeah.
Well, guess what?
What?
We're not just going to give it to you just like that. We want to see if you are such a good wheeler dealer as you've just made out, okay? You've just said how you make this money and how this one's worth that and that one's worth that. You've got to make £49.99 by wheelering and dealering here on the Big Breakfast over the week. And we're not going to give you any tips or any hints, but see if you can do it by Friday.
Okay.
Do you take up the challenge?
Yeah.
Okay. Take it back away. We'll see tomorrow. Okay? The challenge is on. This is Channel 4. And you are watching... Oh, no. Time for the crunch with Zig and Zag. That's it. Now.
Zig, does it hear when I bite you down here?
Does
it hear when I bite you down here? Really?
No.
No, okay.
Ian and anorak on.
What?
It would have been quite sore.
I didn't really do it. Okay, well, it's a very exciting
we'll
day.
We'll only know. You'll never know.
Well, Zig will know. John Wheatley.
John Wheatley.
Who plays Joe in Coronation. He's going to be here later on.
He's going to be in later.
Hi, Chris.
John.
Lovely to have you here, mate. Lovely to see him, isn't it?
It's lovely to see him.
He's keen but early.
A bit keen.
Keen but early. You're an hour early, John.
An hour.
Yeah, go and have a cup of tea. Meet the crew.
Have a chat with the crew. Nice fella. A bit keen.
He's so keen.
He's keen. Look at the time.
Watch his please to Zig. Thank you very much indeed. You know the address. Now, come on.
Send money.
Chris, there's another thing that's meant to his address.
What? And by God,
I know what you're talking about,
Zag.
Because it's time once again for the Agony Alien.
Agony Alien! Now, look, can we all calm down, Rob? Come on, we've got a lot of problems to get through this morning. Come on,
We've got
a lot of problems to get through this morning, everyone. So
just one, just
okay.
one.
Okay, all right.
Okay, you ready, Agony?
I am, yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Because it takes a lot out of Zig,
it does.
Because he gives.
I've really got to clear my mind of everything that's bothering me or, you know, surroundings at the moment. Just
cut it.
I've really got to help this person, whoever it is. Don't worry.
Well, I'll tell you who it is.
I'll be with you in a minute.
And if there's a bad atmosphere in the bathroom, which sometimes there is, believe it or not.
Oh, sometimes there is.
You have to shut that out.
Oh, I can believe
it. Shut it out. All right?
Yeah.
You ready, Agony?
Come on.
Agony's ready.
Come on. The alien? Here we go. Dear!
Let us up.
Okay. It's on the script over here. It doesn't matter.
Oh.
Dear Agony Alien. Recently, I made an enormous decision to have my hair cut short. But as I watched each beautiful strand fall to the floor, it was like watching treasured pieces of my life just slipping away. Since then, I've been a miserable introvert, unable to look anyone in the eye, and unable to murmur a breath of conversation. I am distraught beyond belief. Please help me, a traumatized, short-haired person who used to be a long-haired person.
Oh, right. Dear. Dear. Lovey.
I was trying to explain one thing. See, how... Zig never speaks during the letter because he's taking it in.
Okay, listen, Lovey. I've got to help this person, by the way. Lovey, first of all, I want to say something to you, Lovey. Lovey, listen.
Maybe in the shop.
I understand. I understand, so don't fret anymore. Now, I want you to come out from behind the sofa. Come on, out from behind the sofa and make yourself a nice cup of milky coffee. Put your feet up. Isn't that better?
Now, listen.
You've had a rather... Listen, Lovey. Come on, boys. Listen, Lovey, you've had a rather... hair-raising experience, to say the least. Just a little pun. But now, I want you to do something for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Take the weather, for example, okay? The weather changes every day. Rain, sun, snow. But the world still turns, Lovey, okay?
It's true.
Now, you've had a change, so now it's your turn to turn. So what I want you to do is I want you to face up to your fringe, Lovey. And remember, it's not just you.
It's all true.
He speaks the truth. He's never been beaten and you took a lot out of you.
I had a big sweep in my mouth as well at the same time. And I've got a bit like
very well.
with the zigzag.
John Wheatley's here, new star from Coronation Street. John,
to
give us a few, what's going to happen in the next week?
Oh, I can't tell you that.
I hate that. Oh, why? Why would they ever tell us?
No, it's more than my job's worth.
Yeah. John, I tell you what, though, I have a question that basically the whole country are wanting to know the answer to, and it's really my duty to ask it, and that is, well, John, did you always want to be a soap star?
No!
You knew it was going to be us, didn't you?
Yeah.
But you're embarrassing someone.
You're embarrassing.
You know the one we book guests now?
Yeah.
Right? We have to tell them about that before they come on.
Why?
Because we've had so many complaints about that question from the guests.
But I'm doing it as duty for the country.
Yeah, all right. Okay, look, Johnny boy!
Yeah.
Johnny
Wheatley's
here! Okay, are you all right there?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
John Wheatley, Connors Street.
What are you doing? What I want to know is, hold your hands up to the camera, please. Hold, and the other one, please.
What? What?
Why is that one much dirtier than that one?
Come on.
What have you been doing with this one?
Nothing.
Right, come on, tell us.
What?
Dick.
John, question one. Yes. Do you have one hand dirtier than the other, and why?
You're not serious.
No, I'm not serious. Okay, no, question number one is this one. Is this one down here? Ziggy boy.
Yep. Oh, let's see. Right. John,
clean fingers, dirty fingers. What's all that about?
John, you are famous for being Joe, the latest Coronation Street star. We want the latest piece of gossip from the street.
Yeah, behind scenes. Yeah.
Behind scenes.
Come on, you have to.
Who's going out with who?
Yeah.
Ken Morley doesn't wear underpants.
Hey! Why not?
Because I bought them.
Gossip from behind the scenes. From
behind,
the
scenes. Christian.
Okay, yes. Johnny boy, you are famous for being Joe.
That's it.
Well,
just one laugh.
Okay, question number two. John, you are famous for being... Can I get on with this? Excuse me.
Go, Chris.
John!
Yes!
You're famous for being Joe, the latest Coronation Street star...
No, stop it.
And you work.
I see if you're down.
I know. And you work a lot with small children. How do you keep them under control? Please demonstrate three methods on Zig and Zag.
Okay, right. First of all, we give them a book and we read them some nursery rhymes. In your case, it's War and Peace.
Oh, very good. Yes, I have read that book. I have read it. Yes, it's about war and the peaceful times.
Yes. Okay. What's this word, Cliff?
That's the again.
Long, very long.
The.
Okay, second, if that doesn't work, we give them a toy.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
that could be on the really
toy. Oh, that's
really cute.
It's
really
cute.
Yeah.
Okay,
good. Okay.
Can you
help? Oh. Oh. That wasn't
okay.
Cute at all.
And third, if that doesn't work.
Cash, let's go.
Yeah.
Hey.
Okay.
Well, all righty.
You're going to be quiet?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
No problem. Yeah. I'll keep it. I keep the money.
Get off.
Okay. Look, I'm just minding it.
Hey, good on. Thank you,
John. You better mind it.
Question number three, Zach.
Yes, indeed. The question is here, indeed. One can now go on see Coronation Street via the Granada Studios tour. John. But can you give us a 1 minute tour of your home?
Can you do that, John?
Okay, hold on.
Okay,
here
we go.
And I came prepared.
Time starts.
No.
Okay. Time starts now?
Yep.
Okay. There is the front of my house.
Hey! All right! Hey!
And there's me, as you can see, with a white shirt there.
Hey! Yeah!
That's
very
nice.
Okay.
This is what you can afford if you go on Coronation Street.
Wow!
Okay.
This
Chris,
is,
that's nearly as big
this
as
is
your house.
The back of the house, as you can see, we're having a little bit of an extension
wow.
there.
Wow!
Hey! There you go.
Hey! Hey! Hey, Mrs.
Wow. So big, isn't it?
Very good.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Interior.
This
sofa.
Is the bedroom.
Oh.
The master bedroom.
Oh, very nice.
Put your dressing gown there, John, on the door.
There are 15 bedrooms, but this is...
What happens in there? Well, hurry!
What, you don't know?
Chris?
You can only ask him, sorry.
Okay, and this is Matt.
Oh!
He's really
Reed, your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up. Your time is up, John.
Oh, thanks,
that was good.
That's Matt.
Who is he then?
He's my cat.
He's your pet cat.
Yeah, he's my pet cat.
Okay, as well as looking after your pet cat and forever whitewashing that huge house of yours, you also play computer games.
Indeed, he does.
Which moves us neatly onto Zach's computer slot.
Indeed, Chris Vance, you know, being an expert. We're going to, just, you know, John, if you're not familiar with games, just, you know, play along, okay? Game number one, Dungeon Masters, out on the Super Nintendo.
He's got it here now, he's got it here.
Yes, indeed. Now, chaos lives in the Master's Dungeon. Apparently, you must explore the dank depths of the labyrinth and find your way to the sacred mountain to retrieve the fire staff from the evil Lord Chaos. Grind your goony loins and search this creepy crypt if you dare. It's at $52.99 US import only.
You've played this before.
I have, yeah.
Huh? It's been out about 4 years.
It's brand new.
It's been out about 4 years, yeah.
What?
On the PC and Amiga and stuff like that. It's a very good game.
Sorry. He knows about video games.
He does genuinely know about everything.
But no one told him.
It took Nintendo 4 years to get it onto a cartridge.
Okay, 52 quid. Is it a good game?
It's a very good game.
Ooh, so it may be worth it if you've got Nintendo.
Why didn't anyone get... I wanted to say that.
Okay,
that
game number two is this prototype here.
It is, because they're at Super Formation Soccer 2 and Super Nintendo.
You've not played this one, have you?
Japanese import only, Christopher. $69.99. You've heard of Super Soccer. But, Dad, you've heard of Striker. So you can, Super Soccer 2, come in and sweep the floor with these other footy favourites. Well, it's not too much of a change from the original concept. You can play with three other mates and you can customise your teams, giving them funny names and stuff. Soccer simulation fans, stick to Striker, I say. Japanese import, $69.99, Super Nintendo.
Why do you say stick to Striker?
Because
there is
it. I told you,
just
say.
Chris.
Come down.
Because
it's
better.
You saw that one then.
It's
not bad,
not bad. It's as good as Kickoff 2, probably.
That's what you should have said. Not stick to second, but it's as good as Kickoff 2. Because John knows. Because John's the guy. John's the man. All right. How long are you going to be in Coronation Street for?
Possibly until Christmas.
We hope he is.
Oh, no!
We've got to say goodbye to Jenny Boy.
Jenny Boy!
Bye, Jenny Boy!
Goodbye!
Bye. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us, John. Bye, this is Big Breakfast and...
Channel 4. Blah, blah.
Fresh fruit, plenty of it. Melon particularly, love melon, can't get enough melon. Watermelon particularly, don't mind rock melon, but mainly watermelon.
Big!
Muesli, keep you regular.
Big breakfast.
Big healthy breakfast. Balance is the key.
Yes, you are watching The Big Breakfast, the luckiest things that have ever happened to you. I broke my arm a week before I had to go to the school dentist and I got a week off school, says Madeline Turner from Redcar. Doesn't sound very lucky to me. Sue Whittingslow from Halsden says, whilst I was watching The Big Breakfast, I was eating a caramel bar and I found out I have just won a CD player.
Woo!
Yes, the luckiest thing. He is quite hunky, isn't he, that guy from Coronation Street? Rapid now, look. The bowl holder is Jonathan Burris.
Hi, Johnny.
I'm holding the bowl.
I've got some pear in my tea.
Oh, right, okay. Okay, now it is time to play Let's Get Wet! Right, a member of the crew or a member of our visiting?
There's no chance of a draw. Someone always gets the shortest straw.
Very good. Yes, in fact, that's exactly what you want to do. We want you to go past here, pick a straw from the bowl, whoever gets the shortest...